guys. My name is Shandell, and I'm here to share a message of hope. I hope you're having a great week. I hope you're having a great day. I'm just happy that you're here with me. So I just want to say hello to all the new subscribers, to all the ones that have been following me for a while. I just thank you so much for the likes, the comments, the shares, taking the time to subscribe to my channel. It just truly means the world to me, because I look forward to bringing you a message every Sunday and just sharing the hope in Jesus Christ, because at the end of the day, that's the only hope we have in this world is Jesus. You know, I lived so long in darkness. I lived a life so long in darkness and of self-seeking and in the world. And then I had my encounter with the Lord and I never looked back. And I know that, you know, when we go on our own understanding and all of these things, we can really mess things up. And when we completely rely on the power of the Holy Spirit and that relationship and that intimacy with God, I mean, your lives change, and it's not promised that it's going to be perfect, but there's a peace and a comfort knowing that we have Abba Father guiding us, teaching us, and loving us and protecting us. So, you know, one of the things that I wanted to talk about today was fasting. Now, God's been putting fasting on my heart a lot lately, and I just wanted to share this with you. And you know, what does fasting do? It makes us strong spiritually. We kill our flesh. We become dependent on God. We seek out God more and we grow spiritually. We become spiritually stronger. And the more we fast, the more we honor God with fasting and all of that, we just grow and we just go to different levels. We go to higher levels, you know? And fasting is for us. Fasting is our spiritual preparation, and breakthroughs happen. And you just grow spiritually. You know, if you look in Isaiah 58:6, it says, "This is not the fast that I have chosen. Oh, is this not the fast I have chosen? To loose the bonds of wickedness, to undo the heavy burdens, to let the oppressed go free, and that you break every yoke." You know, I love that scripture for fasting because, you know, you have breakthrough. If you're being like tormented, all of these things, you go into a fast and you seek God out, right? And things break off, you know, chains break off, bondages break off, burdens break off. You get encouraged, you get strengthened, and it's amazing. And, you know, it's hard to fast. I mean, especially when you go on a full on water fast, that's hard. But the more that you do it, the more you'll want to do it, the more you get strengthened, you know? So I just encourage you, you know, right now, me and my church, we're doing a 21-day Daniel fast. You know, and it's a good reset for the year, right? And then after that, I'll continue on going to fasting. And, you know, even the word of God says, we don't have to share a fast with anyone. It's you and the Lord, right? To not let people know that you're fasting, but to have that, you know, washed face and just keep on going, right? Daniel is a good book to read about fasting too. I love the book of Daniel, and he gives a very good example on fasting. Moses fasted before he wrote the Ten Commandments. Jesus went to go fast 40 days and 40 nights, you know. That would be awesome. And I hope one day that I can go on a 40-day water fast, you know, just being a mom and work and all of those things, you know, just trying to find the time to do that would be a challenge right now. But, you know, I'm praying, but I'm still doing my fasting because it's just another way to honor the Lord. So I want you to pray with me. And I want to encourage you to seek the Lord out for a fast. What is God calling you to do right now? Seek out the Lord, pray, okay, God, how can I fast for you right now? You know, because we can put God at the center of all that we do, even our fast, right? Seeking out the Lord, okay, what kind of fast do you want me to do? Pray on it, stick with it, and watch your spiritual breakthroughs. Watch your breakthroughs happen, and amazing things will happen in your life, and you'll become even more spiritually strong, right? We can tithe, we can read, we can pray, but also incorporating fasting into those things too, and we just get more spiritually strong. So I want you to pray with me. I want you to open your heart up, open up your mind to God. You know, when we pray, we go in with expected hearts, knowing that God's going to move, knowing that there's going to be production from our prayer, right? Things are going to be produced. Things are going to happen when we pray. Maybe not be right away, but our conversation to God. And that's another way to be spiritually strengthened. So have an open heart, have an open mind, and expect God to move and see what he does. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord God, we come before you. Lord, we come before you in the mighty name of Jesus. We have expectant hearts. We have open minds, Lord God, to just receive what you have for us, Holy Spirit. I pray, Father, for anybody that is fasting, I just pray a strength over their body right now. I pray, Father, for you to give revelation on another fast to go through, Lord God. I pray, Father, just for more revelation of your word, Lord God. I pray for a revelation of prayer, more wisdom, Father. The word of God says, if we pray for wisdom, you liberally give it to us, Lord God. I pray, Father, for such an equipping, Lord God, as such a strengthening, Father. I pray for the peace of God right now to overwhelm our lives, Lord God, a joy. I pray, Father, for guidance, clear direction on all the things that we have in our hearts and our minds right now, Lord God. And I just thank you, Father, that you are a real, live, tangible God that loves us, that equips us, that strengthens us spiritually, Father. So I just pray right now, Lord God, that whatever anybody's going through, we break every stronghold on our life right now, every tormenting, harassing thing. I break it now in Jesus' mighty name, and I command it to go now in the name of Jesus. And I thank you for that, Lord God. And I pray, Father, for just a peace to overwhelm us, a strengthening to arise inside of us, faith to arise inside of us. Father, I pray, Lord God, that you would stir everything inside that you have placed inside of us, Father. And I just pray for more hunger, more fire, Lord God, to just do kingdom business, to do what we can to be the best servants of you, Lord God. And I pray for revelation. Father, I pray that you just fill us with more revelation, Lord God. And I pray, Father, that we have a clear direction on how we can best serve you, Father. I pray for peace. I pray for comfort of the Holy Spirit to fill us now in Jesus' mighty name. And I just pray for a supernatural turnaround on whatever the person that's praying with me is going through, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. We give you the praise. We give you the honor and glory, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. If you heard any weird noises right now, that was my dog. He's in here with me. All right. Well, I just encourage you guys to go on a fast, pray, seek the Lord first, and see what he reveals to you. And, you know, just make God a priority in your life. Make prayer a priority. Make reading the word a priority, and your life is going to radically change. You're going to be strengthened spiritually just to places you never thought possible. All right. Well, I hope you guys have a great day. I hope you guys have a great week, and I'll see you next Sunday. Take care.